end up with a situation that from one hand side we have huge demand for data scientists from many companies. And from the other hand side, we have many data scientists with some experience about how to create machine learning models. And that's why huge companies like Google, AWS, or Microsoft, they invented something that they called the machine learning services. And this idea is really cool because it's very easy to use. You need to just log in to this software, to this data as a inside as a service software, and you can use it. You can create models, and out of the box you will create something called data products. And from the however, you don't have much control. What infrastructure are you using? If it's raw open source or not? And that's why some companies like whole finance industry, they are using infrastructure as a service because they have very confidential data, and they need to be prepared for audits, and also the data needs to be secure. And in our company, we chose the third part, which is a little bit from the first part, a little bit from the third one. And we create our own machine learning services, which we call Data Ocean. And what Data Ocean is? Data Ocean is a platform that from one side you have raw data. Then you can create machine learning or AI component to analyze this data and to create some insights based on this data, like data products, business intelligence reports, and business intelligence tools. Or even you can extract the data. Also inside Data Ocean, Data Ocean is also a single source of truth for our data. We have more than 50 different sources inside this platform. It's really nice to have this kind of platform inside the company. And today, I said that I will explain you how we are creating data products. That's why I will focus most on data products. And to create a great product, you need to have a vision. How you would like to create it. And we had one, we called it FIRE, because it's acronym of flexibility, inspection ready, reproducibility, and easy to use. And we would like to have this product to be exactly like that. And based on that workflow, we created our data product architecture, and the flexibility we gain because we used Docker containers. We are ready for inspection because we are using Bitbucket code repository. This is Git code repository, but from the Atlassian suite and Resume, and Artifactory, which is scanned by Black Duck. Reproducibility, of course, Docker containers. I will say a few more words about that in a minute. Code repository, Bitbucket, and easy to use. On-demand infrastructure from AWS, Jenkins Automation Job. We are also using some visualization tools like Dash, or we're just creating APIs in Flux. Okay, right now we have a vision how to create product. Data product architect. However, today I would like to focus on our best practices. And our best practices are Docker containers, CI/CD practices, code reviews, project templates, code standards. We are also using test-driven development, version control, and industrialization, which means we are doing exploration phase in the notebook, and then we are creating Python models to industrialize whatever product we create. And today, I will show you a couple of them. I will focus on the upper part, and I will start from Docker containers. Let's see. Docker containers are really great stuff. It's really great stuff because you have freedom to install whatever you want. It's very easy to install it, And also, you can reuse these Docker containers as many times as you want. And I can tell you from my experience, we are working in four hubs. One is in Tokyo, one in Lausanne, Amsterdam, and Krakow. I'm based in Krakow, and I was working together with guys from Tokyo. And they were creating some recommender system. And my project was pretty similar. And I took the Docker, I ran it. I used just one command. I ran it, and then I, of course, you can add something top of the Docker. If you need some additional features, you can easily add these features. Also, another thing very important: you are working in the isolation in your environment. Everyone in a project, every software developer in a project, every data scientist working in one environment. And this is really good because maybe you can tell us from your experience that sometimes if someone is working in different environment, using different libraries with different versions, then when you would like to integrate everything, it's really hard to do that. And in Docker containers, you don't have such situations. And of course, you can deploy and use it and create one container really fast. In our case, we have few specific Dockers. Whenever we have more than 100 gigs of data, we are using Docker that is combined with our cluster based on data ocean. And then we can use framework, Spark framework to analyze a bigger amount of data really fast. Another thing, project templates. We took it from the software developers for you. And also we are using awesome process here. Which is well known in the data science community. And this is about obtaining, scrubbing, exploration,
modeling, and industrialization. And going back to the situation when I had a similar project to my colleagues from Tokyo, and then I reused the Docker, but I also, it was really simple for me and really fast to find places where I would like to add something. For example, I need to add some features in the modeling part. Also, I was using different sources of my data. That's why I was changing something in the obtain, scrubbing, and then modeling. But the core I had. And the third thing, I think the most important one, the CI/CD practices. And I will start that from a Charles Darwin quote. It's not the strongest of the species that survive, nor the most intelligent, but the one that is most responsive to change. And this quote, I think that is about CI/CD practices. And working in Scrum environment, we need to contact our clients every two weeks. And many times they just change their requirements, and we need to change also our direction. And thanks CI/CD, it's really simple because CI/CD is for that. And I will explain what CI/CD is. CI, continuous integration, you need to really often integrate your code with your colleagues to have something that you can use. Continuous delivery, you need to have code in a deploy ready state all the time. If you will finish project in the middle of the project, then you need to have something tangible, something that's working. And continuous deployment, which means this is the actual act of pushing your new version to your end users. And we need to remember that data scientist, the position data scientist, is right now is crucial for the companies. Maybe a little bit we have a hype for the data scientists right now. That's for sure. However, machine learning is really, really important. And in our case, we have a few steps. We are doing exploration phase. First, we are doing exploration phase. We explore the data, create some models, and then we can easily change direction. We call it alpha phase. Then we have in beta phase, we are creating usually some web-based application for the users. They need to be user-friendly and they can use it, play with it and check if everything is correct, if they like the product. And then at the end, when we create this data product, we can generate the value for the company. And I think that this is the most important part of our job. And we are using cutting-edge technology, and to be at the top all the time of this technology, we have a couple of things on our radar right now. And there are MLflow, OnNNX, also Dask, Kubernetes Parklands, and Binder. There are really nice softwares or libraries. And Dask, for example, is a library that is really similar to Pandas. How many of you know Pandas? All of you. Dask? Couple of them. Great. Dask is really similar to Pandas. However, you can work in a distributed environment thanks to this library. OnNNX, really nice community, I would like to say. These open source neural networks, also really good. MLflow is for the monitoring purposes of the models, and not only the models, also entire projects. Binder, if you'd like to change your Git repository into a notebooks, interaction notebooks, then Binder is something for you. And Kubernetes Parklands is also for the monitoring purposes with the project, with the Spark jobs. And as I said, I'm a part of the best practices ambassador community. And if you don't have one right now, it's really good to have it. And you can create this kind of community inside your company. And I think that you will grow with that. Of course, what we are doing, what you can do inside this kind of communities. You can present some talks. You can also prepare some internal trainings for the newcomers. We are also bringing and spreading the knowledge about the newest technology on the market. And it's really nice. And to sum up, creating data products, creating a software, is not an easy task. And I'm sure that you cannot do it alone. You need to cooperate with data engineers. You need to cooperate with DevOps. You need to remember that data scientist is a person that can gather the requirements from the business, and then together in the multidisciplinary teams, together he can create something which is bigger than machine learning model and which is data product. I hope that during this presentation you learned something. Maybe you will use something out of that in your company And thank you very much. Right now we'll have a few minutes for question Q&A session. And of course, after this session, I am also ready to answer your questions. Thank you very much.